Hi, my name is Irene, and on this video we will discuss difference between linking and importing CAD drawings when we are working in Revit. So let's get to it, shall we? Alright, so when we are working in Revit, a great advantage is that we can bring CAD drawings such as AutoCAD files to use as reference to make sure that we can both build our models faster but also more accurately. And when it comes to bringing those CAD drawings into Revit, you will have two options. You will have the option of linking the CAD file or importing. Both options can be found under the Insert tab. Here is Link CAD and here is Import CAD. Now, in terms of like the procedure, it is exactly the same for both. The difference will come later. So I'm going to start with linking a CAD file. So to do that, I'm going to click here and I'm going to select a condo project that I have. I'm going to leave all of the default options as they are. The only one that I'm going to change is the positioning. I'm going to set it up so it's manual center. So that way I'm not just going to have the link and imported file just overlapping over each other. So I'm going to say open. Here is my linked Revit file. Click and now it is placed. Now let's bring in the imported CAD file. So I'm going to go import CAD, select. Again, everything stays the same except manual center positioning. Open and place. Okay, so what's the difference?
They're the same picture.
So the good news is that when it comes to the line drawings and whatnot, it is exactly the same. So if you're in a hurry and you don't really care, just go with whichever one you can reach first. It's not the end of the world. The difference will come with the way that we're going to be using the drawing. So linking basically means that your CAD drawing will work as an external reference, which is a feature that we know and love within AutoCAD. An external reference file basically means that the original file exists outside of Revit, and what you are seeing in Revit is more almost like a hologram of that drawing. Now, the main disadvantage of this is that you cannot modify this linked file. When I select the file, you can delete layers. That is something that you have control to, but you cannot explode them. So after I brought my CAD drawing as a link, I cannot modify it in any way. If I would want to do a modification, I have to go back to the original AutoCAD drawing. So let's say that I want to delete this hatch. So I'm going to select and delete. So I'm going to have to do whatever modifications I need to do. I have to do them directly in the AutoCAD file, save that AutoCAD file, and then come back to Revit and update the link. To do that, you can find the option Manage Links. And if you go under CAD format, you will find the condo project. Click on it, click reload, and now we're gonna say okay. So now that I've saved my CAD drawing, I'm gonna go back into Revit. I'm gonna go under Manage Links, CAD format, select my condo project and reload. Now say okay, and there you go, the change has occurred. Now again, this is quite problematic if you don't have AutoCAD, because then it means that once you bring that CAD drawing, you can't do anything to it. So what is the purpose of the link option? Well, the link option is going to be extremely handy when you are working with what I like to call a live drawing. This basically means that the CAD drawing that you have given is not necessarily the final form. For example, if you are working in collaboration with an architecture team and they are working in AutoCAD, what may happen is that you guys are going to be working in parallel. It's not like the architects are going to do their entire share of the job, finish, and then give you the drawing for you to work. Instead, you guys are developing the proposal together. So what's going to happen is that they may be sending you updated floor plans once a week or once every couple days. So in those cases, it is extremely handy to work with a Link CAD because it's going to make the workflow a lot easier. Anytime that you get a new drawing, you just replace the previous CAD drawing with the new version and reload, and that's it. You have the new drawing and you can quickly see whatever discrepancies, whatever changes have occurred. On the other hand, when you bring a CAD file as an import, there is no link between the CAD file and the Revit file. It's basically a copy of the CAD file that you have created within Revit. So for example, when I select my imported CAD, I can delete layers like I could with the link file, but now I have the option of exploding the file. So if I come here and I do, for example, a full explode, it's gonna take a while depending on, you know, how busy your drawing is. It's gonna delete some elements that usually will happen with hatching. So I'm gonna come here, delete elements, but once that has happened, I can now come here and start modifying my drawing. So in what scenario would you use this? Well, this is perfect. Again, if you are bringing a CAD drawing to be used as detailing, so for example, you have like a wall detailing or a millwork detailing that you want to bring in and then modify while you have it in Revit, that's perfect scenario. That's a little trick that we can learn in later videos. But basically, because there is no link between the original and the new file, you can do anything that you want to this iteration of the CAD drawing. But if we are talking in the context of floor plans, you're gonna do that when you're working with a limited scope project. So for example, imagine that you're working with a heritage building. Once they give you that floor plan of the heritage building, it's not like they're gonna call you a month from now and be like, oh yeah, you know that 200-year-old wall? Yeah, we moved it, you know, 4 feet to the right. Can you modify that in your project? No, it's a heritage building. Nobody can touch it. However it is, it is. Once you've used the floor plan as a reference to trace it, you know that it's not going to change. Another scenario would be, for example, let's say that you're working with an apartment building project like this floor plan is. The walls that are within the apartment, you may be able to change any way that you want, but the perimeter walls themselves are fixed. You can't come and say, oh yeah, you know what, I just really want to make the apartment bigger, so I'm gonna go ahead and take a couple feet away from the neighbor. I'm sure they'll be fine about it. I'm sure that there's not gonna be issues with structural integrity or fireproofing. It's fine, it's fine. So in those scenarios where you basically know that you have an infrastructure that is not going to change, you can just use the import option, bring in your reference drawing, use it as a tracing template, and then you can get rid of it. In order to get rid of the drawings that you have brought, it's a little bit different between a linked file and an imported file. In the case of the linked file, all you have to do is go to Manage Links, CAD Format, you're gonna select the file, and you are going to remove it, and there it is gone. While in the case of a imported CAD file, you're just gonna select the file and delete, and that's it. Pretty easy, super handy. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, please make sure to press the like button, also subscribe, that way you can know whenever new videos come in. You can check on for notifications, and if you have any questions or there are any topics that you would like me to cover, feel free to leave a comment. Otherwise, I will see you in the next video. Bye!